You may be seated.
Okay.
Okay, let the record reflect that the defendant is present along with counsel for the defendant, Assistant State Attorney. You may continue.
An issue has arisen, Judge. May we approach?
No, about what?
Logistics.
The camera, sir.
And what about them?
My laptop's still visible on the camera.
I have instructed them not to photograph your laptop. Do we have any evidence that they have violated that order?
I saw it. I went behind and looked at the camera, and I asked if it could be moved to the other side, and
I previously said, Mr. Cameraman, are you recording anything on their laptops?
I have a wide shot I can show you, Your Honor, where it is indiscernible, and it's hardly ever on the wide shot. I'm usually on whoever is presenting for the defense or the prosecution and witness stand, but it's very far back when there is a wide shot, and it is indiscernible.
Okay, then what's the problem if it's indiscernible?
The problem is as he moves up, people who are watching can actually videotape the screen and they can see as he's moving up. I'm sure they will be able to see my laptop. It's open. I'm looking at the laptop. The other problem, which is what I'd like to, if you could have a very...
Yes, ma'am. Okay, Mr. Vass.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Vass, your peer-reviewed articles deal with buried human remains, do they not?
The first one did exclusively, yes.
Okay, and this has to do with basically, well, let me rephrase that. Part of your findings had to also took into account the effects that the soil has on the decompositional chemicals, correct?
And you need to define effects for me.
Does the soil affect what chemicals come out?
It may or may not.
Okay. Did you indicate any of that in your papers?
We looked at environmental parameters such as barometric pressure, rainfall, but I'm pretty sure we didn't include soil type because we only had one type of soil out there.
And part of your well, let me ask you this: is it your belief that the soil affects the decompositional odors?
I think it can affect the migration of them. Yes.
And is it your findings as well that depending on how low or how steep a body is buried, that also affects the odor, the decompositional database and the chemicals that come out?
It affects the plume flow, yes.
Okay. And in your 2008 paper, well, actually, let me, before I go to that, this study was also done over a period of years, was it not?
Now, which study, sir?
The study that was the basis for the 04 and 08 paper?
Yes, it was a multi-year project, yes.
And was it your findings that it took approximately 17 days before chemicals reached the surface?
In a burial situation, yes.
And the 08 study, you had also included surface?
That is correct.
Okay, bodies on the surface?
That's correct.
Okay. And is chloroform detected on surface decomposition, sir?
Let me refer to my article and make absolutely sure my answer, if that's okay with you.
Oh, go right ahead.
Chloroform, according to Table 1 in the 2008 paper, is not a component of surface aerobic decomposition.
So unless the body is buried, you don't get chloroform. You didn't get chloroform in your study.
Incorrect. I'm talking about oxygen deprivation. Okay. Burial just happens to be the method of oxygen deprivation in this study.
How did you distinguish the two?
Well, oxygen deprivation can occur by wrapping somebody in something, removing the air from some place, something of that nature.
How did you come to that determination during this study?
Because any situation where the environment becomes anaerobic, chloroform was detected, even in very shallow burials.
That's quite a leap, though. You're making a bold assertion that it only has to do with anaerobic conditions. Is that not correct? You didn't test in the study.
Objection, compound question.
Let him finish asking the question. Do not immediately answer a question after he asks. Let there be a pause so the state can interpose an objection.
Let me correct my objection. It wasn't a compound question. It was a question asked and not permitted to be answered and then followed by another question. So it really wasn't a compound part. It was two questions. So let me correct my
objection. I'll rephrase this, Judge.
Okay.
Sorry.
You didn't study different conditions to make that blanket statement that it is only in anaerobic conditions.
I'm still confused with the question. Blanket conditions means what to you?
You made a conclusion that chloroform was not detected in surface conditions, correct?
Yes, bodies lying surface open decomposition. On the surface. That's okay. Correct.
And I asked you then, following that, was that unless a body is buried, you won't get chloroform in decomposition, and your answer to that was no, correct?
I would say any situation which provides anaerobic conditions would cause it. Burial is just one of those.
And the issue that I have, or the question that I'm going to ask you, is with the word any. In your 2008 study, you were only dealing with buried remains and surface remains. Yeah, let me rephrase that. You're only dealing with buried bodies or bodies above ground.
Correct, but some of the bodies above ground were wrapped in body bags, for instance, which would tend to eliminate some of the oxygen.
So your conclusions that any decomposition as to chloroform is based on body bags and buried?
Objection, Your Honor. I don't believe the witness has made that statement. That can explain more to the bench if you need me to. It assumes a statement that the witness hasn't made.
He can answer correct. He can answer.
The difficulty here is that counsel is stating a question, assuming the witness has made the statement that chloroform is never found in aerobic
decomp. That's not what he said. He said his study didn't find it. He's never given the opinion that it can't occur. That's my objection.
Objection would be overruled. The witness can, I think, is amply qualified to say what he said or didn't say.
You only are you including just body bags and the soil to make that conclusion? Any?
Well, we have surface individuals as well with no body bags, no wrappings, no sheets over them, anything of that nature. But for this particular study, that is true. Now, we've done a lot of casework as well.
Okay, so that is true. We're only talking about bodies and body bags or soil to say that chloroform did not appear in those two studies.
For this particular study, I would say that's correct.
Okay. Now, do you not make the assertion in your 2008 paper, and this is after years of studying human decomposition, correct? That it is interesting to note that.
Objection, Your Honor, could we have a citation so that.
Yes, page 390 on his under discussion. If you want to follow along, Doctor, I'm referring.
What's the name of the article, the date of the article?
It's 2008 article of odor analysis of decomposing buried human remains.
I have page 390. Can I ask what line, what portion of the page? So
first column, last paragraph. It is interesting to note that many of the 30 compounds in Table 1 are not very unique and can in fact be found in many outdoor samples taken virtually anywhere. You make that assertion, do you not, Doctor?
Absolutely, yes.
Okay. And after studying for many years of human decomposition, it's your conclusion that these top 30 compounds, which you find most relevant to human decomposition, can be found virtually anywhere.
As individual components.
Okay.
As a mix, that's a different issue.
Do you state that in your discussion there, or is that sentence complete?
The sentence you read is exactly that individual components, I mean, many of the 30 compounds are not very unique. We do decompose. We go from a very complex matrix into essentially very simple organic compounds, and those are not very unique.
So the conclusions for which you base your opinion are based not on the chemicals, but the combination of chemicals.
Which conclusion am I basing?
For this case.
Yes, it is not the individual components. It is the fact that all those components were found in one particular location.
Okay, we'll get to that in a moment. Do you, on the next column, conclude also that this study has shown that, for the most part...
Where is this?
Set the next column over, second column, second paragraph.
Oh, okay.
This study has shown that, for the most part, human decompositional end products are not very unique... in the chemical world.
Objection. Ask the council complete the context of the paragraph. Please.
You can do that on
redirection.
Sustain, read the whole thing.
Included in Table 1 are the maximum surface concentrations of each compound from both the test and control samples observed during the course of this study. Test sample maximums were always higher than corresponding control maximums. Should I read any further?
Yes, just full paragraph, please.
Since each test compound began at level equal to or below those seen for control samples, no minimum value for each test compound is reported. To provide some guidance for future development, analytical detection instrumentation, it is suggested that for the maximum values for each compound in the control samples represent the minimum compound concentrations. Okay. The rest of that paragraph doesn't detract from your statement, does it?
I don't think so. The first sentence essentially reiterated what we already agreed on.
Okay.